Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah.
I love you, baby.
I love you too. Who is that texting you?
Nobody, baby. Don't worry about it.
Nobody. It says Tina. Who the fuck is Tina? Who the fuck is Tina?
Bitch, you know what? Get your shit and get out.
You know what? I love you, babe, but maybe we should take a break.
A break? Maybe you should kiss my ass.
Sound familiar? You in a relationship and this shit ain't working. It's time for the truth. This is the Voice of Reason with Zoe Williams.
The truth. Oof. The truth. The truth?
The truth.
The truth. Ladies and gentlemen, the Voice of Reason is back in the building on Dash Radio and Hot Button Radio. Dash is the app. Hot Button is the station. If you can't hear it, the only reason why I'm saying this is because we're going to upload these shows to YouTube. You'll be able to watch them. But if you can't hear it live, it's because you don't have the Dash Radio app. Download the app and then tune into Hot Button Radio Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 5 to 7 p.m. It's on fire, the Voice of Reason. This is what we do. And again, another crazy topic. You know, we have the craziest topics in the game, I believe. We're not afraid to talk about anything. And today is no exception to the rule. Before I give up the topic, I want to introduce the girls. Whitney is high and drunk.
What are you saying right
She's
now?
She's suffering from a hangover.
Man, that was last night. I was drunk last night, man. Come on. Don't put my business in the streets.
Whitney got on glasses. It's a bad situation right now.
I'm a little under the weather, guys. But I made it. You're welcome. I'm just kidding.
She looks like a tennis star, man. You know,
this is my Hamptons housewife swag right now.
Yeah, first off, people don't understand how beautiful and voluptuous and curvy Whitney is. And then she comes in here in this little Serena Williams outfit, and it's
Freaky Friday, right? I mean, yeah. I'm not gonna reveal the topic, but maybe that's somebody's thing.
Wow. Yeah, I love it. I love it. I love it. And Ashanti Ford is in the building, ladies and gentlemen.
Hello.
This is going to be a crazy topic. Let's get to it. Get to your phone lines, 844-55-1, 844-55-1. We're taking callers because we want to know, like Whitney just said, it's Freaky Friday. So, fantasies and fetishes, a penetrating look into the good, the enlightenment, the rough, the bad, the repression, the violence, and the ugly of unrestricted, uninhibited sex. Fetishes and fantasies. Do you know a lot of people who have a fetish? And have you heard of some strange fetish? Now, our crack producer, Chris, has pulled up.
You don't do Chris like that, though.
First off, it doesn't mean you're on crack, Flavor Flav. Jesus.
It's funny.
It just means you're good at what you do. You're crack, our crack producer.
We can't get enough.
Producer who's on crack.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
It's a difference.
Thanks.
Jesus. So, I like to ask questions. Is the strap-on used by many studs a type of fetish? A lesbian fetish? That's an interesting one, yeah? I think it's interesting. Even Chris went even further. I didn't want to go that far. And then Veronica, of course, is going to join us. Hecka is going to join us. Veronica was saying that it is possible to have sexual intercourse at a distance, like long distance sex. And it is as good in a long distance. I'm like, somebody got to practice on me. That, you know how to do it too?
Without Skype? No Skype?
No, like long distance energetic sex. I don't know.
I watched a crazy movie called The Paperboy, and I had never seen it. It's about a serial killer guy and a chick who's like all infatuated with prison dudes. Maybe that's somebody's fetish. There it is. She goes to visit him. She's wearing a skirt. He straight up tells her, open your legs. And she like does. They literally were like 4 or 5 feet, and they both like he busted and everything.
Whack. Wow.
She was just sitting in front of him. It was crazy. He was just like
whack, and it's weird.
I'm with it.
What are some of the weirdest? Do you guys have a list? What are some of the weirdest fetishes you've ever heard of? 844-55-1 is the number to dial. Call in right now and share your fantasy or fetish. Can you listen? I think the vibrator for a lot of women have become, you know, the fetish of choice. They might not say it's a fetish, but the vibrator is important, right? For a lot of women.
Very.
They can't get off without it. I'm just saying. 844-55-1. Somebody call me. I don't know. Speak on it. Ashanti, do you have a list of fetishes?
Me personally?
Oh,
yeah. No.
Or
the text message
like,
that you received.
Oh, okay, that's what Jesus. I was. Yeah, that's what I was, let me just.
She's like, you want me to bust my list out? Because she's going to just let. I was waiting. Zoe, man.
Are we on the true or false hype right now?
No. Okay.
No, well, there is some crazy. No, I got a list. Here, you want to hear?
Yeah, I didn't get a list of texts.
There is some crazy stuff going on in these streets.
In these streets?
I'm saying, look, so I have the top 10 fetishes, I guess we want to say.
Here we go.
We'll start at 10. Adult babies. Number what? 9. Yeah, adult babies. I actually, a friend of mine has a Facebook friend, and he is a grown man who wears diapers. He wants
that
a woman to
fucking whack.
Wipe his ass, powder him.
Am I
like,
the only person listening to this shit?
Yeah. And whack. And there's like chat rooms. He found a girlfriend. Like, ladies and gentlemen, I just want to announce he did find a girlfriend who also does the baby diaper thing. And they
the baby fucking
on my
diaper
life.
Thing,
it's yeah, they like grown people wearing diapers. Anyway, number 9, swinging or group sex or orgies. Number 8, water sports, arousal by urine. So golden showers, right? Is that what we're talking about? Number 7, cross dressing. 6, foot worship. I think foot worshiping should be not number 6. It definitely needs to be like number 1 or 2. I'm just saying, because I have people requesting me to take pictures on my Instagram of just my feet.
Really?
On everything. It's crazy. Number 5, spanking.
Okay, I like that one.
Oh, we all got right. We got there an we Ashanti. Go. There it is. There Less. It is.
Well, why would spanking be a fetish?
I mean, it's kind of like pain and pleasure in one. You know what I mean? Let's say, how can it not? For example, like, I don't want no niggas sucking or praying on my toes, but you could spank it or smack it one time. You know, that's hot. In the midst of it, depending on the position. Spanking and smacking.
I'm all right. I'm cool with this. I mean, if you hit me a couple times, smack I'm okay with that. Time. But I would be more down with the foot thing, man. I rub my feet, bro, because I literally, I'm tired as hell.
Okay, that's good.
You can.
Okay.
Well, I don't know. I've never dipped into that. I haven't found anybody that I've wanted to worship my feet. But if you guys want to worship my feet, you can call us at 1-844-55-1.
Have you guys ever heard of Mandingo parties?
No.
I've heard of something like it. What is a Mandingo party?
So is this a circle jerk? Is that what host? A bunch of guys hang out? And
there's Whitney.
I'm just saying. Is that what it is? I don't know.
So the Mandingo party, just look it up. Okay. Look it up. I want to see your faces when you find out. I don't want to tell you. Mandingo party.
Mandingo party.
We're talking about fantasies and fetishes, and I think a good question to ask when we bring Veronica in, do these fantasies and fetishes grow out of like a repressed state? Like you never get what you really want and then you start getting real crazy about it. You know, you start creating all of these different desires because, you know, you're never really fulfilled. Veronica Conway is on the line. Veronica, talk to me right now.
Yeah, I think that most fetishes, you know, if we really look at sex in its highest and most powerful state, everything is orgasmic on a woman's body. Her eyelashes, her toes, her fingernails. And so the idea of localizing it and then turning it to a mental game, what that means is that someone, because see, sexuality is like an ocean, and a woman's sexuality especially is like an ocean. And when people have to experience shame or some traumatic event or something where they got shamed around their sexuality, it tends to take that ocean and tamper it down and turn it into a creek or like a drip. And so that is the nature. That's how, because sex is an energy. It's a very powerful energy. But when we have mental trauma around it or repression around it, it ends up becoming a sort of a mental obsession. Whereas I think real sex is a physical and spiritual embodiment. Mm.
So you're basically telling me most people are not having sex. They're just fucking? What's going on? What are people doing? If they're not doing it right, what are they doing?
They're practicing friction.
Damn.
We're just rubbing on each other.
That's hurtful.
That's about it.
Damn. That's hurtful.
Good long
shit.
Hump.
Okay. Veronica, do you have any fetishes?
Yes.
Oh. She said that quick.
No, because I think that but I've been sexually awakened by a very powerful man, and I think all sex is sex. It's nothing to fetishize. It's all sex is the ocean. There's nothing to fetishize.
Wow, ladies, any fetishes to speak of?
I like to be choked.
I'm kind of into that too.
Really dope.
I like to be slammed into walls.
No, you're bullshitting.
No, it's nice.
Oh, this is good.
Yeah, it's nice. You know, it's again that whole pain thing with the pleasure. I don't like being called a bitch or a slut, though. I'm not really down with that.
You take the physical abuse, yes, but the emotional abuse, right. The verbal abuse is not cool.
Punch me in the face right now, but you better not.
Ever call me a bitch.
Don't you ever do it.
Yeah, I like the pain.
So. I don't classify what I like as being a fetish, I guess. Mm-hmm. I didn't think using a vibrator, if that's the case, then I guess I got a vibrating fetish. So definitely like those.
How often do you use your vibrator?
I mean, a lot. Let's just a daily.
Lot.
You want to know every day or no? Probably once or twice a week.
I'm trying to.
It depends
into
on
it.
How long of a week I had.
Okay, you're good. You're not fetished up.
Okay, yeah, I don't really.
But you
use
just
it.
Wake up, use it, go to bed, use it, eat lunch, use it, bowl of cereal, use it.
But there are people. No, I went into the little sex shop and there was a lipstick. This would piss me off because if I went in Shanti's bag, like, girl, can I borrow your lipstick? That's cute. And I grab it and realize it's a fake lipstick because it's a vibrator. They have those.
No, but I hear that some women wear like this. What is, I don't
the
know
panties.
What
the panties,
yeah, the panties that vibrate all day long.
Yeah, I'm about to get me
no, at work, some of those. Busting off, juicing off in the corporate chairs.
The batteries die too quick on those.
Oh, Ashanti said
Jackrabbit.
That.
Yeah,
they die.
The
too
batteries die too soon on those. So they're not all they're hyped up to.
Ashanti's
be.
Little jelly boxes get been worked out.
Well, shit,
Jesus.
No, I tried it on this date that we went on, and like. We had the little vibrator button, but it went out before the date was over.
That would kind of, I'm into that. That would be kind of fly.
So y'all like, just eating and talking, and it's just jackrabbiting off.
She gave the button to her man. So they're sitting there eating dinner, and he's like.
Yeah, I would get up to go to the bathroom.
And she's like, okay.
That's awesome.
That's kind of,
it was hot.
That's like some Magneto fucking.
I'm going to add that to write that down, girl. Let me write this down.
I love it. What is that called?
They're called different things, but if you go on Amazon, you can put in vibrator panties and a ton of different lines will pop up.
Boom.
It's only like I have 20 more, bucks. Too.
There's a couple more on this list here. Number 3, rubber, latex, and leather.
What is that?
People who, man, you ain't never seen. So come on, man. I'm gonna need you to
tell me about
step up your game here. Latex, like women will put on their whole like body covered in latex. like Missy Elliott in the black bag, but not Missy Elliott in the black bag. If that makes sense.
Okay. How is that hot though?
Like skin tight, like leather, like she looks like a superhero.
Like BDSM type stuff.
Like, yeah, leather, latex. I'm sure they smack each other with leather. You might get into that, Ashanti.
Yeah, I like
that. Number two is role playing. I'm team with the role playing all day. I was with that back in the day. Like,
but you know what? I ask a lot of questions, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I think an important question to ask is, why is everybody so afraid of the fetish and fantasy conversation sexually? A lot of people are afraid to really open up and share what it is they want, how they want it. I mean, sex has hella taboo wrapped around it. Why is that the case?
People don't want to be judged.
You mean women don't want to be judged?
Even sometimes men.
Men don't give two shakes of a fat rat's ass.
That's not true. That's not true. There was this guy that I was dating one time, and it took a year for him to admit that he liked a finger in his butt.
Ooh.
That was his thing.
What's that called?
Yeah, and if you wait a few more years, he's going to admit some other shit, too.
Also, I don't really like your finger. I like John's finger.
I didn't really like that. You know, I didn't like that at all.
I'm not getting my nails dirty. I'm sorry.
I didn't like that's... it. Like, I'm not trying to have my fingers smell like man ass.
Right. Like, this nigga subsists off of a diet of ramen noodles. This shit is bad.
Man, yeah, I feel like that's it though. People
might want to go vegan.
People don't
want to be. And then sometimes if you come all the way out in your sexual being, maybe you may be unrecognizable to yourself and you'll be embarrassed about it.
Well, the show that we had on divorce, when my ex called in, and this is something I didn't even know. He said Whit was very adventurous or like
creative. He said
creative in the. I'm almost like.
That piqued all of our interest.
I was like, well, shit, I didn't even know. I and then my current. Fuck buddy also was like, you're pretty. I'm like, well,
fuck buddy, this is really good. Jesus.
My current fuck buddy was like, you're like hyper sexual. I'm like, man,
Veronica,
get with it or get lost.
Veronica, boom. Why is there so much fear, you know, about, you know, just being real as it pertains to sexuality, one sexuality? What did the church do to sex? What happened?
Well, the thing is it's, you know, they have taken it and turned it so upside down and so inside out. I mean, if you really look at, if you go back into, you know, Jesus or Mary Magdalene, all of that was centered around the mystery school. So they talk about Mary Magdalene as being a prostitute in the Bible, but really she was, if she existed, she was a student of the mystery school. In the mystery school, they were using sex magic as a staircase to God. Right. And so I think that the church, in order to get control over the masses, needed to make sexuality a sin and install the mechanism of guilt around it. Because if you think about it, everything gets born to the planet by that creative act of sexuality. And so people that are in touch with their sexuality without shame or guilt have a direct connection to God. So if the church needs to be a middleman and insert themselves in the conversation, you have to introduce the concept of sin. So that's why the whole conversation is polluted. It's polluted with all of this guilt, can't talk about it, can't be about it thing.
Wow.
That's crazy.
I have a question.
That was heavy right there. Go
ahead,
Ashanti.
I have a question for Veronica in terms of the church. Is it true that once you have sex with someone, the church says that you're married to them? The Bible says that you're now married to them once you have sex with them.
I don't know where that verse is.
I've read about that.
You read that verse?
What the church does is it takes things that exist in metaphysics, things that exist in the energy world, and it takes them and takes the real nature of it, and then it distorts it. So what is true is that when you interact with someone, especially when a woman interacts with a man, she takes him into her body and she becomes courted to him, wedded to him in a certain way. So, but they've taken that. And they used it to promote the institution of marriage because they really wanted to get your property. So the reason that religion is so successful, if you want to put it that way, is because it points to things that humans recognize as real spiritual phenomena, and it points to just enough of it that we know that it's of God, or we know that it's a natural thing, occurrence, but we internalize it through a system of dogma and guilt.
But Veronica, so, wait. Veronica, yeah. Wait 1 second. Yeah. What if I have a midget fetish? Is that of God? Like, I just desire little bubble bootied midgets.
You got issues, y'all.
Ha!
Real shit.
I'm just saying.
See, Judgy Judy over here.
Right, Judgy Judy.
Why
what if
you gotta
like,
call it a little midget bubble butt, though? Like,
midgets have bubble booties.
Yeah, but you can't just say, what if
jealous.
I like a midget?
I need midget. I want some.
Midget's
I
ass
a little
is way
midget
better
bubble
than yours.
Bubble booty. Here we go with the dumb shit.
No, Ashanti's ass is quite astounding.
Yeah, she do have two midget booties back there.
She does.
Like.
She does.
Looking, it's looking good.
Right. Ass
keep
was made by Spalding. It's very, very palmable. But yeah, I'm just saying, you know, because some people, you know, just down and dirty with it. Just they like midgets. Is that of God?
I think it's all backwards. I think that the fetishes came as a result of the church, not the other way around. And if you want to look at the largest fetishistic institution in the world, it would be the pedophilic Catholic Church. Right?
Yikes. Mm. All my Catholics out there, holla at me. 844-55-1. Ain't no guilt here. Y'all good. Y'all
You're
can
good.
Come through. 844-55-1.
Calling all Catholics.
Continue, Veronica.
Well, I was just saying that, so which came first, the chicken or the egg? So fetish came after, you know, the priests and the politicians are in cahoots. So
wow.
Fetish and as a disruption of the natural order of things sexually came after the institution of guilt, not the other way around.
Wow.
Humans used to be more natural.
So you're telling me sex is kind of like some law of attraction shit. And the church was like, hell nah, let's suppress that, make it evil.
We're hijacking.
We're going, right. This is all dirty and foul and devil and pornographic, which that's in Revelations. The secret name of the beast in the book of Revelation in Greek is pornography. So are you telling me this is how they set up the death of the law of attraction via sex? Speak on it.
Well, what they did was they kept it for themselves, and they gave whatever is passing for morality today to the masses, so that we can run around and bump around here on this earth, fucking crazy, while they, you know, collect all of the money and the power and the land. And believe me, in the higher realms of the church, they use sex magic, they use all of this stuff, so that they can accrue wealth and power to themselves. So they just gave the rest to us.
Do you think morality and sexual freedom can exist in the same space? I think it can.
Why not?
What's your definition of morality?
Well, you shouldn't fuck little boys and girls. I think that's foul. And the Catholic Church has proven that little boys and girls are on the menu.
Ooh.
I mean, I'm not trying to be funny.
You know why they do that? They do that as a way to gain power. They use sex magic and sacrifice with little children to gain power. That's
it sounds
all
like
about
the church is really demonic.
Yeah, really.
I don't mean to say that. Like, I'm naive about all of this. Is the church demonic in that way? 844-55-1. Jesus.
Yo, I feel like that's how, like, Veronica literally just said it. That's how they, you know, how kids are so scared of their parents. That's what the church pretty much just did to everybody. Is that what we're, that's pretty much it, right?
Wow.
Like,
how many
people, the church
made
people scared to have sex.
Like, how many people are, like, in relationships and in marriages where their partner hasn't taken them there? Like, they're afraid to really wave the freak flag on a motherfucker for fear of some kind of moral condemnation from their partner. Like, I didn't know you was this type of hoe. Jesus,
yeah, well,
I married Mary Magdalene and it's just.
But that's really it, though. Like, that's why people aren't so openly, you know.
Sexual.
Yeah, like people are scared because they're going to get judged. Like there's a lot of things that I'm trying to get into, but I'm kind of like, let me just ease in.
What is it that you want to get into, Whitney?
man, I don't really know. But I'm just like, do whatever makes you feel good.
And man, if it, I don't really know.
And, you know, if you need to grab... No, I was going to say some real random shit, but that's, y'all might think I really want some... What about... You know what's one? Look, I'm in my head right now. I just woke up, by the way. You know what's that... Do people really put, like, gerbils and little, like, hamsters in their butts? Like, that's whoa. Not that's cool, man.
What was that? Richard Gere did. He shifted gears on that, for sure.
It is so wild. Wait,
but when the thing comes out of their butt, is it still alive? Like, the little pet mouse? Or is it
probably
dead?
Not. Yeah, it's
that's
probably
a pretty tight...
probably a gerbil burrito by then.
What is it? What happens? So I need to... Where's this Googler? I need to check it out, man. What?
Oh, God.
We didn't even get to number one. The number one... fetish is guess what, Shanti? What do you think is the number one fetish?
How about drinking bath water?
What?
That could. I mean, I've been asked to drink that bath water.
Hey, hold on, that might be pot liquor.
We can make some money off that.
Little bath water.
1-844-55-1. If you would like to call in and talk about how you want to drink Shanti's bath water, we got
yum,
you.
Yum.
We're selling it for cheap.
Right. Got that water for the low, low.
No, so the number one fetish is, Zoe, you know? You
probably, I don't.
You don't know?
No.
Anybody know? Anybody know? Submission and whipping.
That's like,
really?
Like, bow down, bitches.
Sure. See?
That's the number one.
Submission. Now, why do you think 50 Shades of Grey was so popular?
See that?
Wow.
Right?
Speak on it.
All about that.
Do you think a lot of women like get into 50 Shades of Grey and being Mary Jane? And what's the other one with the girl with the skeleton face? Sarah Jessica Parker. You know, she used to be really pretty back in the day.
I don't even know what you're talking about.
What's Sex in the City?
Oh, that's my shit.
That's the shit.
Right?
Yeah. I thought it was a scary movie. I was going to say Hocus Pocus.
Sarah Jessica Parker's face just...
I think she's cute.
Yeah, it was.
It's
back
sunk
in, the day.
And
yeah,
all.
It's kind of sunk in. You know, white people like bananas.
Skinny.
She's older.
Don't get too skinny.
But do you think they just escape into these sexual TV shows because they're so repressed, Veronica?
Well, I think that there's a crazy sort of agenda in the media to portray women a particular way and to repress the feminine on the planet. And so if you can kind of play women out of pocket by having them sit down in front of the hypnosis machine and take in, you know, ideas about what a woman is and what a woman is capable of, then she doesn't have enough, between that and survival, she doesn't have enough bandwidth to really go deeper into what she's actually capable of.
Is this the internet or what?
Boom.
What are we doing? Bandwidth. Say more.
Well, I mean, a woman is capable of so much more sexually than, you know, and what gets portrayed in the media, mainstream media, as sexy or whatever has nothing to do with how a woman functions, has nothing to do with how orgasmic she is, has nothing to do with what she's capable of bringing a man to in his experience. None of what we see portrayed on television has anything to do with how women really operate if they are connected with and activated appropriately.
Well, what happens if your sexual fetish turns into a sexual compulsion where you just gotta have it? Because remember, the definition for fetish is you literally can't get off unless you have the object. Fetish is a Greek word for object.
Mm.
Right? So
see, I've never actually experienced that, maybe.
Like, you can't get off unless you have this object. So what happens when your fetish becomes a compulsion and now you gotta have it, and this shit turns into like an
addiction?
Your
life is ruined.
It sounds
then you
dangerous.
Gotta get off. What's that show? We're going to have to sit down and be like, listen up. This
first 48.
Like, first 48. I was thinking intervention. Look, you and this vibrator need to chill out, all right? It's been too much. It's affecting all of our lives. Like, do people really go through that? I want to know, does anybody, Veronica, Ashanti?
I haven't.
Has any of your fetish, I mean, if you are into any fetishes, have they affected any of your relationships? Like, how does that work?
It's Freaky Friday. Have you ever? it's Freaky Friday. It's the Voice of Reason. We're here on Hot Button Radio. Dash Radio is the app. You got to download it in order to get it, you know, to hear this show weekly. We're here 3 times a week. This is a crazy topic, fantasies and fetishes. An in-depth look into the good, the bad, the ugly, the enlightenment. Sex is a conduit for enlightenment. They say it's spiritual. Oh, God. But As Ashanti has explained, sex is probably some of the best consensual violence you could ever have with your partner. 844-55-1. That's the number to dial. Veronica's over here laughing. We got to take a quick break. When I come back, I'm going right to the phone lines. Mike from D.C., I see you. The phone lines are starting to heat up. 844-55-1. Get in now so you can talk to us about your fetish. We'll be back.
I mean...
This is Zoe Williams, the voice of reason. We're not afraid of any topic. And listening to that record, it feels like hip-hop is fetish music now. Right? Or fantasy music. I mean, it's talking about everything now.
Nicki Minaj's Trouble Butter.
Honestly, real life, that nothing. Nobody does any of the shit that they're doing in the music. I'm just saying.
I don't think so.
No, I'm like, no, you're not fucking 12 bitches at the same time and all that jazz.
Wrong.
I don't believe it.
I don't believe it.
I do not.
Listen, we have a caller on the line. I want to welcome everybody back. If you're just tuning in to the Voice of Reason on Hot Button Radio Dash Radio, we're talking about fantasies and fetishes. Fetishes are crazy. Give me one more just really crazy fetish before I go to the phone call, right? To the phone line. What's the real crazy one, Whitney?
I did them all. That was the top 10, but let's think.
Did anybody find out what a Mandingo party is?
Oh, no, we did not find out.
I put that in Google and some pornos popped up.
Really?
You
have porno saved in your phone?
No, but it
you
just
went to Pornhub. Didn't
I did
you?
Not. I yes, googled it, and did. Pornhub popped up.
She did.
She
yeah.
has. A, she's a.
She's already
username.
Showed us who she is on this show.
The same.
Violent
what
sex.
What is a mandingo? How do you spell mandingo?
I have
you
the
just
urban
lost
dictionary.
All your African roots.
How do you spell mandingo? What is the definition of mandingo?
Listen, if our Twitter followers are following this conversation, whoever knows what a mandingo party is, tweet me right now and I'll shout you out right now on the air. 844-55-1 is the number to dial. 844-55-1 is the number to dial. And also, follow me on Twitter at Zoe Williams.
So wait, do you want the real definition or the Urban Dictionary? I really like Urban
Dictionary. Go to Urban Dictionary,
Yeah, okay.
Let's get real.
So let's peep this. Hold on. Let's see. It's coming. Mandingo party.
What is it?
By definition from the Urban Dictionary. Black poles, white holes.
No, go down. There's more.
Hold on. I don't... This is...
Did you write this entry?
She's like, no, actually.
No, because I've had it up, but I'm just, you know.
A mandingo party is an interracial orgy arranged for single black men called bulls to have sex with or gangbang white wives or daughters in front of their white husbands or that's fathers true. Called chucks.
Cucks.
What
so,
the fuck?
Well, first off, who wrote this? Quentin Tarantino? Is this like... is this like the screenplay for Django 2? This is
what?
Bad.
No, there's wait more, a though. Minute. I need to reread this. This is crazy. So what? Black dudes, basically, let's break it down in wit language. Big old black dick dudes, is that what I'm just going to say, having sex or banging.
We are of a special breed.
White little girls and their wives while their dad watches? This is some fucked up.
This is real business out here in these streets.
What?
Out here in these streets, it's really going
somebody
down.
Somebody really put it on Urban Dictionary, so they really are a fan of it. That is insane. That's the craziest. So there it is.
Wow. Let's go to the phone lines real quick. We've got Mike from D.C. You're on the line. Holla at me, brother.
Hey, what's up, Zoe? What's up, lady?
What up?
What's happening, man?
What's up, bro? Hey, Zoe, right quick, bro. I just want to apologize for accidentally rehashing your message last week, man, because sometimes, like, your shows kind of resonate to me on the soul level, so sometimes I get ahead of myself. So I apologize for
come
that.
Come on, man. It's all love, bro.
All good.
I wanted to ask you and the lady this question. I did have a girl who said she wanted to play Ray with me.
What?
And she said she wanted me to choke her with my belt and slap her.
Hey,
she
Mike.
She was kind of like...
Mike, your phone is pop locking right now, but just hold on because I want you to finish your thought. But it's breaking up a little bit. But Mike said something that's real. I've had that request.
Shut up.
Tear my motherfucking pantyhose off and bust this thing down. I'll drive me like Mr. Perfect, nigga.
But wait, so you, what? So wait.
Word.
I think I heard what he said. He
Chokeouts, all of it.
He said that she said she wants to play Ray.
She wants to play Ray.
Play and Ray should never
Let's do it this way. Let's do it this way. Ladies, I know you're out there listening because y'all be on some bullshit just listening and scared to pick up your damn phone. And I ain't going to say nothing. These niggas is talking crazy. Get to your goddamn phone lines and call me and tell me if you've ever requested that. Because a lot of girls, I mean, a couple of girls that I've dated have asked me
to play rape,
to just come in like an assailant, lights out, and just find the box and take it. Well, the jelly box.
That's great. I mean, I've done, I like Ashanti said earlier, I'm kind of into like a light choking.
Light choking?
A light choking would do, sir. But
just grab my neck. Just hold
but like
it.
I'm more like role playing kind of go like I'm into the role playing, but I don't want like a burglar. I got a gun player. Don't come in my house. Honey, I just wanted to play.
Is there a kind of exhilaration to being choked? Ashanti?
I think so. You know, speak not about but it. It's an art to it because you can't choke too hard. You can't push the middle of the neck too hard. It has to be just right around the sides.
Would you show
of
me?
The neck.
Maybe choke, later. Please choke, though, because there's been a couple times maybe I wanted later. To choke this nigga for cutting my mic.
Literally.
As a matter of fact,
damn it.
Thank you. And she's gone. And scene. Thank you. Veronica, can you speak to that while Whitney is on punishment?
I think that women, see, a lot of times fetishes become an approximation for what we're really craving. And so rape is really being taken and having to surrender and being claimed.
Ooh.
And having no choice.
Ooh, ooh, say what, more. Go deeper.
That's the experience that women are really after. They settle for that as an approximation, a rape fantasy. But what they really want is to be claimed, and what they really want is to experience surrender. And they'll keep playing that out until they get the nearest approximation.
Are there any dudes out there who can't bust off unless they're watching their woman masturbate? This is a fetish.
I'm into
we
that.
Have a list, you know.
Dabbled.
It's called menophilia. I can't get off unless I'm watching her scramble her eggs. 844-55-1. Somebody get to the phone.
I've definitely tapped into the let's masturbate together thing. I think that's kind of hot, right? Like, just be next to each other. Don't even, like...
I swear, Whitney is a closet freak for real.
I'm just... And just try new shit, man. Just experience life, man. Y'all slipping.
I just don't get off
is
on
there
the masturbation.
Anything more beautiful? Is there anything more beautiful than when watching a woman give herself pleasure?
See?
Is there anything really more than that?
Nope. Me and Veronica are liberated sexually. Let's do this.
Oh, God.
It's Friday. I'm
you guys are wilding right now. Go ahead,
you know
Veronica.
What they say is the thing that is the most watched in pornography?
What?
You would think it would be like, they have studies to prove this. You would think it would be like penetration or the this and the that. The thing that is most watched by people in pornography, men usually, is a woman's eyes, is a woman's expression.
Hey,
her face,
when she when she's giving me the old pole worship and she's looking me in the eyes, it is quite possibly the best moment of my life.
Yo, I used to have a dude
look
that would
this into your being.
That's deep.
Look at me in the eyes. And I was like, man, this is kind of awkward for me. I don't really I gotta low key would be like, dang, man, why do I gotta okay, well, I'm looking at you.
Oh, God.
But and see me, I got the worst face. Like my O faces is like exorcist. Faces. You feel me? Like I'm like really I'm just saying, and I was like, dang. I even had a dude be like, why'd you make that face? And I'm like, because I was, she was going good. But he's like, but it wasn't a good looking face. I'm like, well, fuck.
So here's some more weirdness. Something called flinching.
Flinching?
Yeah.
Like,
or felching. F-E-L.
Felching.
C-H-I-N-G. Felching.
What's that?
Is a sexual practice in which a person sucks semen out of another person's vagina or anus.
Belching.
With or without a straw.
What?
Yeah, it's getting bad, ladies and gentlemen. It's an ass slurpee. What's going on?
Damn. I am feeling a little queasy today. I might have to run to the bathroom real quick and throw up. Wait a minute.
What is going on?
Felching. So wait, who partakes in the felching? I mean, is it more like...
Damn sure ain't gonna be me.
Is there like a felch.com? Do you find somebody?
I can tell you that right now, motherfucker. It ain't gonna be me. Wow. This is gonna get me off, boo. You're gonna be on the hook.
There's a few, I mean... I don't know if these are classified as, there's like, what is it, like a rhino punch, they call it. Like basically, right when you're smacking from the back and the dude punches the girl in the ribs and she makes like a hunchback, like.
Let me ask you a question. Rhino-like. Have you ever been rhino punched with
no,
me? Some
I'm not.
Shit is going bad
I'm
with
not.
Me.
I'm not. I swear. Because like I work at a recording studio, so we talk, surrounded by dudes, so they talk about the nastiest, craziest shit, so that's why I know. There's another one, ready for this though, yeah. Kind of goes into the felching land, I think.
The land of felching.
So basically, guy busts in her mouth.
Bust.
Yeah. Bust.
Say it again.
Bust in her mouth.
Ugh.
And then punches her in the face.
What?
So then when she cries, red and white come out, and it's called a candy cane.
Wow. Okay.
There's like a whole bunch of these crazy. I'm like, wait a minute.
This is bad.
A chicken cutlet?
Yeah, this is bad. This is bad. I mean, this is really bad. My question is, and we talked about this earlier, Veronica. We talked about like this sadistic shit. You know, where we want to hurt each other. Is that like, because you know, they always say in relationship, there is an inherent amount of power, right? And typically somebody has more power than the other person and it vacillates back and forth. This type of sexuality, do you think it's a display of one's power over the other person? Because a lot of people will tell you that's what rape is about. It's not about the sex. It's about the power of taking someone against their will. And to me, these fetishes and these fantasies kind of really creep borderline up to that line of extremism. What do you think of that?
If you really study it, you will discover that a lot of that was created in Europe. And in the caves, the Caucasus Mountains.
Oh, Jesus. You about to blame the white man again, huh? The white man created this nastiness, didn't he? Say on it. Speak on it.
The relationship between sex and violence really got, and all that in Greece and in ancient Rome, all of that got sort of institutionalized back then. So it is a power relationship if you think that that's power. I think it's an approximation to power. Because I think that if a man is really, I mean, like, activated and giving it to a woman, that is the most powerful state you can be in. So violence is just an approximation.
Wow.
It is. And so, yeah, it's power, but it's an approximation. It's not real power.
Wow. Sinister Mephisto on Instagram or on Twitter says, a donkey punch during anal makes her spaz up and it tightens her up. Like, you would do that. That's crazy.
Wow.
The Adjuster, at The Adjuster 7 says, Whitney's dude is in trouble tonight.
Yeah.
Whoever that dude is about to get... Anyway. We have so many people. Isaiah Smith on Twitter says, dang... Why did I get the show right when it turned the corner? Cheese and grits is what he said. I don't know what that means.
Cheese and grits, man.
It's a lot of tweets here. I can't read them all. Oh, my God. It's at least 100 right now. Somebody, Theodore, I don't know. What is he? At K Welcome BA says, what the hell are y'all talking about tonight?
I'm
with him.
Yo, I'm learning all kinds of crazy stuff on the internet. I don't know if you can read. There is a fetish. Sorry, though, I had to talk. This, an arousal from amputees. I can't even.
What?
like getting off because of, they don't have legs.
Hey, put your stump on me.
Yo.
That's going to get me right on off.
Plastic foot all over my back. Like, what?
Maybe that's what Paul McCartney was into when he married the girl with the one leg.
She came up, man.
I don't know.
Oh, wow, what about those crazy furry things?
What are those?
They have furries are basically people who wear like plush suits, like a cat or a Minnie Mouse outfit, and then go run off and do each other in like a bunny costume.
Wow, this is
they do. It's crazy. They have conferences. They have like conferences that they spend millions of dollars on, and it's crazy.
It's insane.
So I just feel like a lot of people just need this hella escape through sex, right? And they're willing to do anything but in secret. And I'm not saying you should be out on fucking La Brea, you know, showing us all what you do. But you wouldn't know the person right next to you gets off on your shoes or will steal your drawers or something. You know, it's people out there that, you know, you don't know, right? Have like these fetishes, man. It's crazy. Listen, we've got a caller on the line right now. D from Maryland, you're on the line. Holla at me, man. What's the word?
Hey, what's up, y'all?
Hey.
What's happening, Mike?
What's up? I had a question to ask everybody. Well, this normally goes for the ladies, and I had this one lady.
You better not ask me a question, nigga. No, go ahead.
I'm sorry. She said she wanted to have a menage. She wanted to have a threesome. She wanted to have the two dudes and one girl. And I was like, why do I have to do it with another dude? Or we can't do it with just me and two women. So my question to, like, the ladies is, how would you rather have your threesomes? With two women or two dudes or two women?
Oh, that's great. Veronica, start with Veronica. Let's put Veronica on the Barbie. Go ahead, Veronica. Answer that question.
I've had sex with two women in my younger, wayward college years.
You had a little taco tasting? Good. It's good, Veronica.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I definitely had a thing for women back in college and dated some women. But I just found them to be too needy.
Women started getting too needy?
Yeah, man.
Wow.
Clingy and like, I was like, oh God, you're a train wreck. I just like to have sex with masters of the universe. And so when you do that, it kind of all gets handled. You know, I don't know. I think that sex can be such a fucking profound, powerful thing that if you find the right person to do it with, it can be better than any of the other little sideshows.
Mm. Wow, good stuff. Good stuff.
I have one more question.
Go ahead, bro.
Oh, she got mad at me, but I wanted to ask y'all, I never tried this and I'm not gay, but I just wanted to know the situation with if a girl sucking the dude dick and the other dude hitting that from the back, is that the only thing two dudes can do that's not homosexual? She got mad because I didn't want to do it.
Let me be clear, because there's a little mumbling in your mouth here. I need to know exactly what she wanted you to do again. You and the guy.
She wanted the position where, you know, you hitting the girl from the back and she's sucking the other dude's dick. And I was like, is that the only thing two dudes can do in the same room? That's not gay, because she got mad because I didn't want to do it.
I think it's an awkward moment when two swords come together, even if there's a woman in the room.
There's one more thing that I think isn't as gay.
I'm just saying, if there's any sack clapping going on, it's not good.
What?
The sack clappers. You guys are clapping each other's sack together.
Sword fighting.
You guys are a little too close. I'm sorry.
What about if
it ain't no switching though, man? That's juice mixing.
Would this be considered? Would this be out of your range if you were like getting off? It's like watching live porn. So one dude is smashing girl, and you're over here just doing your own thing. I don't think that's that gay. You can do that in the room and be cool if that's your thing. It's like watching live porn.
No.
It's like a nice show. You're going to a show, cool. Dinner and a show.
I'm straight. Ashanti. two guys.
I'd rather watch it do the porn.
Or two girls.
Well, I'm bi.
Hey, thanks,
so
D. We appreciate it, man. Appreciate the call.
Did you, Zoe just.
No, I did not. Heard
did
everything.
You heard
she said,
heard
I'm
it.
Bi.
Oh.
I heard that.
I would rather two girls than two guys.
Ashante.
Two guys is like a train.
Yeah. There's a, you know, there's, that's right. The hoe zone. We don't do that. Yeah.
Well, you guys are tiptoeing in contradiction world here. So let's take it easy before I have to pull you back into reality. Whitney, two guys, two girls.
I definitely would do the two girl thing. I haven't, but yeah, that would be it.
Wow. This is an amazing show.
Yeah, no, honestly, you know what? Confession time. You know me, I just keep it 1,000. I don't know how else to do it. I watch porn. I just started dipping into porn land, and I only like girl-on-girl porn.
Really?
Is that weird? Not. Don't no. care if it's weird,
not weird
or not.
Because
I like, I, that's, no. like, I don't like watching a chick get just rammed through. That's not it. Right. I'm not into it. I don't want any gerbils running around. I don't want any. So I just like the, like, making out, like, sensually little, like, ooh, brr, and then.
Violent dry humping.
Oh, is that you? That's your cup
I'm
of tea?
Just saying, that's what two girls really is. It's like violent.
Yeah, but and I'm not even into the scissoring thing. I'm not into that's where that's.
Mr. BS, Mr. BS on Twitter says that some fetishes are legal raping. We've got Hekka activated on the line right now.
Hekka.
Hekka, I don't know if you've been listening to the squalor that is this show right now, but we are down. We are down dirty in the depths of things. Mm-hmm. Can you speak to it?
Yeah, I mean, I've been in and out because the system has kept cutting in and out on me. But I just think that a lot of the fetishes that I did here are what I consider lower vibrational energy. No offense to anybody, but it's just what I feel. Because in my opinion, sex was created as a tool for conscious expansion. It's supposed to be used for the cleansing of our emotional body and the manifestation of our desires in the earth realm. So how can we cleanse the emotional body if we're being thrown up against the walls and choked and eating one another's feces? Mm. How can we do that?
Yeah, I mean, people do eat boo-boo chips.
You are so disgusting.
Dark energy that is entered into our energy fields to fester and grow. So we're becoming more and more confused on a daily basis. The more we do it, the more confused we become.
Hierophilia. Sexual arousal from religious or sacred objects. There's a lot of nastiness going on in the world and nobody knows about
it. And there's so, for, I feel like how many people have to start doing those sort of things for it to become a thing? Like, there's a lot, there's obviously got to be a lot of people that want to masturbate with a crucifix or whatever. So I just, I don't know. I mean, I that was me guessing what they do with
all of this shit is sick and wild.
Listen, you need to stop.
I'm just saying.
Because you have shown your sick wildness.
The freak flag. Fly your freak flag, bro.
Gerbils, though. Eating shit, though. Golden rain, though.
Hey, I mean, some women of the highest moral fabric and fiber enjoy a golden shower every now and again.
I just like the way you say, you know what, man? You just got to have a golden shower and you'll be fine.
I know a couple of sisters that are real cool. You know, real good people, good moms.
Sure.
You know, hey, drop that piss off.
you are so stupid.
listen, my ex-girlfriend begged me for 6.5 years to eat my ass.
She wanted to eat your ass.
Yes, and I never let her. Like, no, I don't know how I'm going to feel about that in the
that's
morning.
That's a good woman because I'm not getting no fucking
but that's what
ass
she
hair
wanted
in my mouth.
So she was probably getting pleasure from that, right? Because you didn't want it.
No.
I mean, I'll rub around it.
Just a man with a moist ass just didn't, you know, for me.
I hate the word moist.
I didn't know how I was going to walk away from that and feel comfortable with me.
Moist ass.
I mean, I've heard that men really like that, though.
I'm just saying, I could be missing out on something, right? A little, just walking away with a damp ass. I don't know.
Yeah.
Veronica, what are you saying, Veronica? Speak to it.
I'm just saying that is hilarious. Okay, like, I don't want to have a moist ass.
No moist ass.
I can't live with myself. That's hilarious.
I just didn't feel good about it. Listen, we got to take a quick break, and then we're coming back. The phone lines are still open, 844-55-1. That is the number to dial. We're talking about fantasies and fetishes, and if you've tuned in and you're a little taken aback, we don't give two shakes of a
don't
fat rat's
care.
Ass.
Or your moist ass.
Right, because we're going to tackle every topic. We're going to do it with humor and ratchetness and insight. So stay tuned. We'll be back in 2.2 seconds. I mean, welcome back to the Voice of Reason. But and of course, this is Dash Radio. Dash is the app. Hot Button Radio is the station. Don't you miss it when, or especially in the radio environment where people just don't keep it real? This is one of those keep it real kind of shows. You know what I mean? Like, we don't have enough of this in the world where we just talk freely without judgment, without condemnation, without condescension. And we're doing it for understanding. Like, we understand that sexuality is private, right? Between you and your partner. But when you start looking at the sexually repressed people, like we kick out these stats every week, damn near, because all of these are relationship topics. So when we're talking about marriage and 27 million, the estimation, 27 million to 40 million marriages are sexless. Or when you look at the numbers on female orgasms, right? 85% of women are estimated to have problems getting a nut. You know, they have to stimulate their clitoris with some type of object or device, right? So these conversations, you know, sometimes they're funny, sometimes they're ratchet. I mean, and we're talking about the different moments in the show. But we have them because I believe just by having the goddamn conversation you've thought your whole life was taboo, is cathartic. I feel like that is a form of catharsis where you're working through the process because you're at least talking about it. And some clinicians or psychiatrists will say when a person that's ill or has some type of mental breakdown, when they cry is when you know that they're coming back to their humanity. If they don't cry, the motherfuckers is really crazy. But when they break down and cry, that's when they start to open up and come back to their normal senses, right? And I think this show is the conduit for this kind of conversation that maybe a lot of people out there aren't having or are afraid to have. With that said, Twitter, @Ty_Small says, I fucked in a church parking lot. It was the best sex I've had ever had in my life. Right by the cross. LOL. That's what he said. I can't make this stuff up.
Well, that's like exhibitionism, right?
Kevin Burnett. Yeah, exhibitionism. Great point.
That's a good...
Kevin Burnett on Twitter says, your ex just wanted you to have the power. She just wanted to have that power over you. Kudos for standing your ground. Yeah, a moist ass is never good.
She'd be like, well, I licked your ass.
Sinister Mephisto, don't knock it till you try it. That's
yeah. That's 2015.
What Sinister said. And then we have another brother here @Heavies_joint. He says, I don't watch porn anymore. The brain is the largest sex organ, so I prefer to stretch my imagination through my own antics. Right? A lot of people are trying to copy porn stars too. Right, that's where the song "Beat It Up," beat this pussy up, beat it up.
And that's the thing, man. I feel like dudes don't understand. Guys, let me know. I'm telling you right now, most girls don't like that porno stuff, man. They're professionals. Leave the professional fucking to the professionals.
Hey, watch your tone and your delivery in the presence of God. Now, really quickly. Do women like to get it beat up? Because I've been asked to beat it up on several occasions, and I have obliged. I need to know from the women.
I'm tapping
do
in right now.
You like the Billy Club beating? Go ahead, Whitney.
Nope. Definitely not into it. Be gentle. It's a vital organ. I need it. So let's not fuck it up. All right. This is my temple. Don't come in fucking shit up. Let's just, you know.
I'm trying to rearrange shit up in there.
Yeah, we're not rearranging. Keep bang, it treated with respect. Bang.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No. No, I'm not into the beating it up. I'm just, no.
Ashanti.
I kind of like to go in slow, and then you definitely need to tear it up.
Yes, oh. This is good. Ashanti's going to get the shit going fucked out of fucking with me, guys. Let me pull back.
Hecka. What about Hecka? Yes, I want to
know. Hecka, let me get back in the radio zone. Hey, Hecka, how are you? Yeah.
Great.
Welcome to the show. I'm good. Can we talk about the beat up scenario?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know.
Yeah, Hecka, like it. I heard it in her voice. She said, yeah.
No, I don't. I don't like anything that remotely looks as if it's being beat up. She's not to be beat up. No, she's a sensitive girl.
Yes.
She don't like all that stuff.
Thank you.
Wow, no. I'm shocked.
Really?
I'm shocked.
Veronica, you?
No. You're shocked, but I don't like
can
it.
Can I give an alternative to the beat up that's the real beat up?
Oh, speak on it then.
Yeah.
Yeah. Veronica. Go ahead, Veronica. But don't Dr. Goulston me, though.
Most women are settling for clitoral stimulation from the clit to have their experience, and those compare not at all to the cervical orgasm. And so if a man were to penetrate a woman and just gently rock back and forth on her cervix, let's say for an hour, where he's just kind of touching it and kind of stroking.
Listen,
it
men ain't got that kind of time. Ugh. An hour. What the fuck?
No, listen,
the game is coming on. We got San Antonio. We got New Mexico now. We got shit to do now, anime. No, go ahead.
Excuse me. So if he were to do that for an hour, just gently stroke her cervix, she would go into an orgasm that was an hour or longer.
Mm-hmm.
And then he could just ride that experience and really begin to witness himself as a God man. That's the real beat up.
That's it.
Let me ask, can all size penises reach that cervical point, or do you need for...
You don't need a mandingo. That's what you're asking.
Do you need an appendage?
That's...
No. You can do it at a distance. You can do it with someone that's halfway around the world on the phone.
Okay, now wait a minute, Veronica. Wait, hold on. Before we set this up, let me just preface this. Because Veronica's about to get deep as shit. As deep.
Literally.
Yes. Because you remember that old Richard Pryor joke? You know, he was like, go on, take your ass out of here. I'm going to get some new pussy. She said, well, if you had 2 inches more dick, you'd find some new pussy here.
Oh.
Right? 2 more inches of dick would get you some new pussy here, nigga.
Let him know.
My whole point is, Veronica is about to get deep. And this is not some shit the average person can, you know, I'm going to fuck this girl in Moscow right now. I can't wait till this show is over. I'm going to go into my Yoda position. And a lot of people don't know about this. So please go slowly, Veronica. Don't, because Veronica will give you some super space age shit, and niggas is like, I don't even. That's not how this works. That's not how any of this works, right? They'll be confused, right? So take your time and explain it to us.
Okay.
Like we're children.
Before I go here, I want the men to understand, because here's the thing that happens a lot of times with men when they hear something that they haven't experienced before. They discount it. Because they think that if it hasn't happened to them, it hasn't happened in the world. And that is simply not true. It just means that they haven't experienced it yet. Right? And these experiences don't often come looking for you. You got to find it. So I want to preface it with that. Because this is real. This is what's happening in the world. Whether it's happening in your experience is a different matter. And the reason that I'm here sharing this is so that you can begin to glimpse what's possible yourself. So if you are talking about
because there's no such thing in time, there's no such real thing as time and space, right? And so, because we're all just in these sort of energetic spaces, we're all space, we're all souls. And so you can have sex at a distance, and the sex at a distance can be more real, as real, more sublime, more powerful, more orgasmic than even anything that you experience in person. Hmm. In some ways, it's more profound because it kind of speaks back to what you were talking about earlier about fetishes and fantasies. When you're having energetic sex at a distance and you're really plugged into a woman and giving her 2-hour orgasms, 3-hour orgasms, and she's riding hour after hour after hour and it's on the phone, then you can't drop into a fantasy or a fetish or be thinking about something else or some porn star. You actually have to be really present in your consciousness with her to be able to maintain that level of connection. So by definition, distant sex, by definition, you can't do it if you're in a fantasy.
Everything in Veronica is saying is from my own personal sex capades or whatever y'all want to call it.
You fucked at a distance too, Whitney?
No, but honestly, like, I've had sex, just plain sex, and it's been lame as hell. Like, guy has a great body and his dick is amazing and it's big and it's nice and it's whatever, but the sex is lame because mentally he was just trying to beat it up and get the hell out of there. Nice. When I'm with somebody who is into me, when there's somebody who's like, he was more worried about me before him, that's that shit that I was like, I need a blanket, nigga. I need a blankie. I don't know what to do. I gotta cry. Remember Yama was on talking about like those orgasms? Yeah, where I didn't know what to do, so I just had to start crying. Like, thank you. I'll take my bank account,
but
do
that's
whatever.
That's what I'm saying. Like, I'm not saying what Veronica is saying isn't true. Mm-hmm. I'm just saying for the average guy, you know, it doesn't average have that.
Average guys learn from porn. They think that fucking like a porn star is beating it up. I'm killing it. King Kong ding-along. Like, nah, man.
King Kong ding-along. I made that up. Wow, that was pretty good.
I'm feeling it.
Hecka.
Yes.
King Kong ding-along is amazing, right? But speak to us about it.
I agree with Veronica. I had sex at a distance, and I'm telling you, it made me turn away from Christianity.
Ooh, shit.
That was, no, really. That
fucked you up out your God. Okay.
Stupid.
Right. Yeah, wow. I mean, it opened me up in ways that I could have never even imagined. And it's not just about that particular moment. I mean, it was days and weeks, and I was still feeling orgasm. Yep. It was that amazing.
Wow.
Yep. We never made physical contact, ever.
Yep. I've definitely... Actually, you know what?
That's that Christ dick.
Man, there has been times... There was a dude that I was talking to out in New York, and we were on the phone for like hours. And I was like, man, hold on. Just the sound of your voice right now is doing it.
But orgasmic, though?
Bam. Jelly box was swimming or whatever y'all talk about. Wet, slipping
Whitney's
and sliding.
Jelly box is beautiful. I bet she has a very beautiful, like attractive, just aesthetically gorgeous jelly box.
Jelly box is hilarious to me,
that's
by the way.
That's probably one of the greatest terms I've ever heard in my life.
Yep.
A jelly box.
Brought to you by Ashanti Ford, guys.
Yes.
I want to hear some of our callers, man. I need you guys to call me 1-844-55-1. Also, if you need the numbers, 1-844-553-2741. Call me, man. I need to hear your fantasies.
I don't want to hear from them at all. I'm surrounded by women, and you guys have interesting stories. Hecka, you were on the, I think you were on hold when we asked this question. Hecka, really quickly, a menage a trois, two guys mm-hmm. or two girls? Which one do you want?
You know, though, honestly, and I don't mean to sound lame or anything, but I just prefer one person. I don't like all that, you know, crowd. Three is a crowd. I mean, all I need is just me and him, and that's it.
She's
that's
making
good.
Sense.
That's
I mean,
good.
I wouldn't prefer either.
That's good.
Because I don't like to share, really, especially dick, man.
So let's do this. Oh, that's interesting.
Girls don't like to share. I, for my own part, I don't like sharing dick. But I don't like to share anything.
Sharing like, clit. Yeah. Go deeper.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I don't know.
I want the other girl to just be a lesbian and not like guys.
You just want your box 8. You're lazy. She's the lazy bisexual. She's like,
talking about using.
And you know what, though?
Using people as a tool. Listen, lesbian mouth. You're here just to lick me because he doesn't know how to do it like you do. Isn't
well,
that
whack? He will be into her, but she won't be into him because she's a lesbian.
Oh, so they're all about you. That's smart. Hmm.
Ladies and gentlemen, a lot is being revealed here this evening. Please say more, you nasty little niblets. I love it all. This is good. I just feel like Charlie from Charlie's Angels right now.
You know what? That kind of taps into what Ashanti was saying, is that kind of taps into the submission thing, or like to be, women want to be conquered. I think that's why that is the number one. I don't want to have to come up with all the fun fetish ideas. I want you to come in the house and be like, girl, I got some whipped cream. What's popping? Like, hey. You know what I mean? Literally. Like, we want to be told what to, I mean, for myself, like, I kind of want a man to be like, listen, this is what we're going to do. We're going to get them vibrating panties. We're going to go to Mastro's. We're going to eat. And I'm just going to
we're
going
to KY.
Just going to get you
I'm
going.
I'm going to KY you all the way down.
Literally.
I'm going to KY your eyebrows because we're going to use them too.
And it's time. It's like, literally, like, the longer the foreplay, the better the orgasm is. I'm saying. That's it.
Veronica, you were going to say something? You were trying to say something.
I was laughing.
Oh, good. Well, you're going to laugh even more with this. At Heavies _ joint on Twitter. I mean, Twitter is on fire right now. This brother said, I'd be like Luke Skywalker if I could have at Veronica Conway as my Yoda.
Ooh.
She is talking some seriously cool shit right now.
Yeah.
Don't try. Do. There is no try. Just do. Put it in.
The reason that I come... And
grind slowly.
Because I've been blessed to have a serious intervention in my life where I could get to have some experiences that most people haven't experienced. And I open up this conversation because I think that we need to understand what's possible for ourselves. I think men need to understand what it means to not have to... You know, I mean, if you turn a woman out in the way that I'm talking about, she just totally surrenders to you.
Is this sex or pimping? Help us.
Experience is real surrender.
Wow. Okay, so let me ask you this. You said earlier, when you and I were talking, you said earlier that sex is a female space. Hmm. It's not really the man's space, right?
Mm-mm.
And with that being said... How do men tap into, or do they really want to tap into this world? Because if they get her somewhere, you know, really deep, and they're not, I think you got to be ready to get a woman, you know, to this threshold. Because if you get her there, tell me what I got to be. I hear you coming in.
You have to be really present. In other words, you know, the thing about reclaiming a woman's orgasmic nature and the thing about having her uncover the part of herself to restore herself to her orgasmicness, because when we're born here, we're born orgasmic. We're born with God's force and life force just powering through us. That's why babies giggle and laugh. I mean, we're born in that condition. And what happens is we grow up on this in this insane asylum, and everything we come into contact with creates more shame, more guilt, more repression, more this. We get a lot of traumatic events that sort of get coded into our thinking. And so by the time a woman reaches adulthood, she's just been all so fucking jammed up from all the conditioning and the programming. But what a man's, part of it is getting her to that place, but part of it is also being willing to stand present with her while she goes back through and revisits all the shame and all the guilt and all the fear and all the stuff and can sort of deconstruct that and burn through that. And on the other side of her facing off with that is this completely surrendered, vulnerable, orgasmic, manifesting goddess that you never knew you had. And what happens is that when they can evoke this in a woman, they come to understand their nature. They come to understand what they were put here for.
and they stop apologizing for being men.
What do you mean? And they understand what they were put here for? Because a lot of men are listening right now. I'm looking at Twitter. The Twitter is crazy right now. Men want to hear this. What are we put here for? This is good. Let's hear it.
Well, I think that, I mean, if you're talking about it, I think men are put here, especially the black men are put here to be gods. That's why we're here. We're the original copy of the creator. But if you're talking about the way what men are put here for in the
He's going to hang up everybody. This is what's going to happen.
Damn it.
Everybody's lost now.
She was tapping into the
she
Yoda.
She was tapping
the Yoda, the Yoda of the Yoni. I'm going to call Veronica. She knows.
There is no try.
Where is she?
Do or do not.
VC, are you there?
You there, VC?
Yeah.
Or Hekka?
Mm-hmm.
We got Hekka and VC, right?
Yeah.
Can you guys hear me?
Hekka? That's Hekka.
Hekka, you there?
Oh, that's not Hekka.
Okay. Well, we got Veronica, right?
Okay.
Okay,
can
good.
You guys hear me?
Yeah, finish
mm-hmm.
your thought, Veronica. You were getting very deep.
So, I mean, a man in relationship to a woman is meant to...
And he just cut her off.
Dang.
She's still there? Where are you, Veronica?
Where far out there?
Oh, this is terrible. I'm going to go right back to Twitter. At the Adjuster 7 says, Miss Tabor is a freak. Me likey. Care to declare your affiliation like Ashanti Ford?
Oh. What? Like bi straight.
I mean,
free.
I've made out with chicks, so I guess, is that considered me bi? I don't know.
Let me say this. I've never licked the jelly box, though.
So why not?
Does that make me not bi?
I don't know. I don't know the
chicks. Okay, this is going to get good. Tell me, why? Why not?
I just don't want to gargle anyone else's juices.
Wow.
Gargling juices.
There seems to be some complexity here. I think Veronica's going to have to read in as well as Hekka. You guys are going to have to heal the young child. Please speak to your sistren. Raise her up to taste the taco and not be afraid. Do not run from it. You cannot live a lie. Speak to it, Veronica.
I find women to be absolutely exquisite, and I understand why men love pussy, because I think that women are fundamentally exquisite creatures.
It's true.
If
Jesus.
They aren't crazy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, you know what I love?
No,
Can I just say something really quick, Veronica? Let me just say something, then you can finish working on Ashanti. I just love that little area, that little gap area, you know? Between the vajayjay and the thigh, where you can see clear through.
Why is that? There's so many guys.
I call it the upside down pyramid. We call it Groom Lake. Oh, it's so beautiful.
Wow.
Hekka, can you help her, please? And then Veronica can finish her thought on that.
Well, I just wanted to make a point about the KY jelly. I think when a woman is being sexually stimulated correctly, she creates her own erotic fluids, and therefore she don't need KY jelly.
Mm-hmm.
So creates her own pot liquor.
KY, yeah, I agree.
He's not doing his job.
I agree.
I mean, because a man only needs to connect with the woman's mind in order for her to excrete her sexual fluids. This
but what true. If she's what if he's too big? What if he's too big?
Big.
Yeah.
Then he better go for it.
There's no such thing.
Even if he's too big, she's still releasing the sexual fluid. It doesn't matter how big he is. She's releasing. She's doing what she should be doing, what the KY jelly was created to do anyway.
No, have you ever been, this is a question for all the ladies. Have you ever been with a man that just dried you up? Start with Ashanti. Just dried up all of...
Yeah, actually, this was during foreplay, and I was really, 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 like, feeling it. And he came up from giving me head, and he kind of sat next to me, and he's like, there it is. And he, like, looked down at his dick, and that really turned me off.
You're welcome.
There it is. Like,
boom.
I was not feeling that shit at all. Like, Mojave Desert after that, bitch.
That's crazy. Damn.
Wow.
There it is.
Whitney?
I have, but it was, we were already in, we weren't in the act physically yet, but we were like foreplaying, and I could tell he wasn't into me. He was not there mentally with
me. Women can feel that.
He was not, and I was like, man, this is a waste of my time. I got to go do some laundry. I'm thinking about doing laundry and shit while we're doing this. This isn't right. So that's when I dropped. She was like, we're closed, sir.
Jesus.
Turn it around.
For business.
Hecka?
Yes, I have. But let me tell you, not only have I had that, and it's just so horrible. To me, it only happens when we're not connecting on a soul level, in my opinion. But I've had it the other way, too. And I can get really wet. And I'm like, I've never used KY jelly in my life. If I come in contact with somebody that's not making my fluids release in the manner in which they should, I don't be bothered with them because it's a waste of my time.
I know that's right.
Can you say making my fluids release one more time?
I like that too.
Making my fluids release.
You go, girl. Release them fluids. Open them walls.
Yeah, this is the fluid show, baby. So stupid. I love it. Veronica Conway. Veronica.
I guess I have. It's been a long time. It's been a long time, but I suppose in my wayward youth, there was the occasional. I've always enjoyed sex, though. But I suppose there was the occasional dude. Usually, dudes that are really egoic and about themselves and me, mine are the ones that just go. I'm like, bye. And
man.
So, you know, if I'm paying attention, then he never gets into my space anyway, because it's like, bye.
Bye, Felicia.
Go make love to yourself in the mirror, right. Dude.
Yeah.
You know, I want to ask this question, too, because this is Freaky Fridays, and this has been a hella freaky show, but I got to ask women this question. Why is it that crazy women have cocaine sprinkled in their coochie? It's the best coochie ever. Why is crazy cooter great cooter? Why?
Adrenaline, man. Everybody wants something wild experience. So guys, they be like, man, I'm going to do this and piss her off. She might slash my tires, but damn, her pussy is so good. Like, is
why?
That it?
Why is it good? Because the girl who got her shit together, she just seems prudish. She seems restricted, reserved, but the crazy girl is like, get up in here, nerd. Bang this bang out.
Kind of like Veronica was saying, the crazy girls are the ones who know what they want. They're crazy to everybody else, but they're just being 1,000. They're being real. That's why everybody likes the crazy girl with the bomb cooter, because they about that life.
I agree. But just to piggyback, though, silent girls are freaky girls too. The silent girl that's going back and forth to school.
I think he's saying is,
listen, you don't have to reinforce your stance.
I'm not doing that.
We know you're the silent girl. We already know.
I'm totally not the silent girl.
We're clear here.
What's your sign?
Answer.
Okay. At One Mad Investor on Twitter says, a woman once turned me off by her moan.
Oh,
sounded like that bitch was lifting weights.
Nice. What?
Hey, listen.
Penguin whale.
I don't want to get too. I don't want to get too personal. But people are asking personal questions. Like, maybe I'll just ask this question to the panel.
You don't want to get too personal.
Come on, with
please.
It, man.
Fall easy, breezy, and let me do my job. Well, I'll just ask this question to everybody because the guy on Twitter asked it, you know, to one person. So I'm going to ask it to everybody. He's just basically asking, have you guys ever done anal? He was asking one person, though.
He was asking me?
No, he wasn't asking Whitney.
Oh,
it's
fine. You? He was asking Zoe?
Me.
Zoe, sir, have
do me
you-
a favor.
Don't turn my
microphone
mic off.
Cut that motherfucker off. And it's off for at least 5 minutes. This motherfucker's on punishment for 5 minutes.
Oh my God. That was.
She might not even make it to the end of the show.
He's like, get out. Just-
right. This shit went bad. But he was asking.
No, I have not tapped into the anal. I've had, but definitely had my salad tossed. Is that the correct term?
He had a moist ass.
Bro. Me, myself. You asked me if I ever did anal, right? Is that what?
Yeah.
And that's a no. Big negative. I'm not into that.
Mm-hmm.
But you can eat it all day. I had a dude just sneak on down. He kept going. And I'm like, oh my gosh. Yeah. And hey, I'm going to let you keep doing it because it's amazing.
Wow. Whitney is the... This is... Listen, I remember when Whitney first came on the show. I was like, this motherfucker tell the truth.
That's it.
She's not scared. I love it, Whitney.
That's all I know, man.
Whitney has gotten the underbody carriage wash. Right? So, Ashanti.
I definitely like getting my ass ate. In terms of anal, though.
This shit is Freaky Friday, ain't it?
It's too much pressure on my chest. Like, Jesus. When it goes in, it's too much pressure on my chest. I just don't like it.
And then you got like really small organs. Don't you? This shit just moving around.
You just push your whole shit up to the, just go up there. That is crazy.
No, and then the one time that I did it too, there was some remnants on his penis that I don't think were supposed to be there.
You mean some truffle butter?
He's just stupid.
Remnants,
booty remnants.
I was not feeling that.
Some
shit.
Booty butter.
This is terrible. This is the worst show we've ever done. This is horrible.
Yes. Yo.
When I come back, I'm going to ask the rest of the panel. We got to take a quick break, but Jesus Christ. The voice of reason. Unreasonable right now. Jesus.
Yes.
The voice of reason has returned. And we are deep, deep.
Literally.
In some shit right now. Welcome back to Hot Button Radio.
Ooh, this getting is the hot for reason. Sure.
Hey, this Freaky Fridays. I mean, and they really got freaky today. At MK Ultra 1186, a sister, and she tagged Whitney and Veronica in her statement, her post. She says, "I hate orgasms."
What?
That's what she said.
Oh no.
That's what she said.
I wouldn't, if it wasn't for orgasms, I would never have sex. I don't want to be rubbing in real life.
What's the point of having sex if you're not trying to get an orgasm? I don't get it.
That's crazy to me. That's sad. I'm sorry, friend. Me.
No friend of mine.
Dang, maybe she should switch teams.
Maybe that's what it is.
Was that how you tapped in, Ashanti?
That's how I double tapped in.
Ooh,
that's
double.
How I Instagram like double tapped.
We're getting too freaky. I need to know. So for everybody tuning in, Zoe just asked if any of us had done anal, and now I'm so I really we're laughing at Twitter. She has a
shitty popcorn dick.
Damn.
Though. Here we go.
Damn to damn damn.
No, the question was for Veronica.
Yes, I'm trying to guess. Hecka,
please get it over there to
I'm
them.
I'm like, Veronica, Hecka, whoever wants to jump in first. Have any of you experienced anal?
Yeah, a long time ago I did, but I am not. I find some cervical is where it's at, y'all. Cervical is where it all lives.
We got cut. You know what? I've not done anal, but I had a friend of mine who helped me become so sexually liberated. She was the one who was like, "You should masturbate. You're tripping. You're losing everything. You know, find yourself." She is a lesbian, or was during that time, and her girlfriend did anal with a strap on, and it, like, she said her asshole bled for like 3 days. So I was definitely, that kind of turned me off. I'm not gonna lie. Hecka,
yeah, that's evil.
Hecka,
that's...
have you ever experienced anal?
Jeez. That's evil. That is evil.
Oh, no, I have never penetrated, but he can licky licky.
See?
It feels good.
Okay.
That's amazing.
Hey, girl. Yeah, Hecka knows what's up. 2015, guys, y'all need to eat the box and the booty.
I'm just going to say, you know, booty and bile are kind of close together. They're there.
Yeah.
I think not.
No?
I think
Zoe is not a butt eater. You're not an ass eater. Is that what we're at?
Zoe's not a butt eater.
Ladies
but
and gentlemen,
so
we.
But close to the other one. So does that
breaking
mean
news,
not
Zoe is not eating? Into the booty eating. Hey.
You could have kept that to yourself.
Nah, man,
no,
experience. You got to let it out, man. You got to let it out. Don't be ashamed of your freakiness, guys.
Jackie Mack. I am Jackie Mack. I have missed the whole at Zoe Williams show. Aww. But turned to it in the middle of foolery. This lady hates what is what
right?
she said.
Right, that's odd.
I need to. Can we call what's our Twitter friend who doesn't have orgasms? Or
somebody
hates orgasms?
Said that woman's pussy has an electrical problem.
No, this may be true though.
But maybe wow. I think
her gyno.
It's not even I feel like a lot of the stuff Veronica and them are saying is so real. Like, people need to understand that it's not about the other person, really. If you're mentally just like, yeah, I'm about to have the bombest orgasm ever, you probably will. Your brain is a very powerful thing. You can just, if you just use it, people, you know what I'm saying? Like, pfft, what? Mm, use your imagination. Ashanti.
Yeah.
We're talking. Oh, I was going to say.
Action follows intent.
There it is. I want to know about fantasies. We're talking about fetishes a lot. What about fantasies? Ashanti, what's your number? Like, if you could, what's your number one fantasy? Go.
Can I? Okay, the fantasy one is hard for me, so I'm going to need a second, but I will share the freakiest thing I've ever done.
Oh, girl, get it.
Yeah, so we're okay. here.
So,
I'm just letting Whitney take over.
I'm sorry.
An ex of mine, his oldest sister was getting married in the church that they all grew up in.
You did the sister?
Can you just wait?
Oh, hold on. It's getting good.
I'm having my own fantasy.
Right. So, my boyfriend at the time, he took me to the bottom of the church to show me where they used to have Sunday school.
Mm-hmm.
And yes. We proceeded to have sex in the bottom of the church while his sister was getting married.
What?
And we literally almost got caught by his grandmother. And it was probably the freakiest, hottest thing that I have ever done.
What is that? Catfish?
Exhibition.
What is that smell down here?
Yo, exhibitionism. That's one of my, I think, fantasies too, is like, doing it on top of a car in the middle of the day just because I don't give up, you know?
It's the hype
like
of it.
It's like, Veronica, what's your fantasy or freakiest
Veronica
thing?
Veronica is.
I know. That's why I keep. Fantasies. I feel like that's why Veronica I keep going to Veronica. I'm getting like, ooh. Is it cold in here fantasy. Or is it just me?
Yeah, she's a Yoda of the pussy. She's beyond fantasies.
There's no such thing as fantasies.
I'm taking notes from Veronica,
it's a
y'all.
5-hour orgasm.
5-hour orgasm.
It's the 5-hour orgasm.
That's
my sense.
That's it. Hekka, I know you got some good shit. Hekka's got some good stuff.
I don't know if mine is that good. I just want to have sex on the beach, butt-ass naked.
Yes.
Miami.
You want sand in your crotch?
They call that a chicken cutlet.
That's what it takes.
That word on the street is if you get sand, when you're doing it, you get sand in there, and then you go, it's like a chicken cutlet because it like... scrapes it. I don't know. I didn't come up with it.
Yeah, you did.
Don't shoot
you
the messenger.
You know all about this shit.
I actually did. Urban Dictionary.
If
that
y'all
is my...
not paying attention right now. If you're not paying attention right now, this is Whitney's topic.
Literally.
Because she is turned up. She in here drunk.
I'm not drunk. Oh, my goodness.
I'm just sitting back watching the show, girl.
No, I mean, hey. I'm a learner of the universe.
Fantasies are always attributed to women. Do you think men have fantasies?
Yeah. But yeah, they're lame though. I feel like most men's lame, like, oh, I want two girls at the same time. Like, oh, that's your fucking that's it. That's as good as you're gonna get. Use your brain.
Whack.
What's the greatest, and I want the Twitter family to do this because Twitter is crazy right now. Brothers who are following, sisters who are following, tweet me at Zoe Williams. I want to know what your greatest fantasy is, sexual fantasy, like most creative stuff. I'm interested to know.
I've definitely.
Hekka, did we get Hekka? Hekka, what's your biggest? Yeah. You said the beach and
beach
sand
the beach.
And yeah, chicken cutlets and all
if
of
that's
that.
That's her thing. That's her thing.
And
Ashanti.
Yes.
Your fantasy, did you tell us?
It's number two. She gave one.
Well, no, that was just the freakiest thing I'd ever done.
Okay, what would be your fantasy?
My fantasy would be to find a guy that was honest and consistent.
That was for Wednesday's show. Man, it's right. Freaky Friday, girl. My fantasy.
As the world turns, starring Ashanti Ford. It's fantasy shit.
Mm-mm. That's what the girl with no orgasms is doing, too. And look, she ain't fucking having no fun. My fantasy would be, like, I want to do some real crazy. I want to, like, visit, like, the dopest cities in the world. Like, maybe, like, some private jet. Maybe we do some freaky shit in the jet. Then we land in
The Mile Fiji, High Club.
And yeah. then we, you know, not just the Mile High Club. Like, I want, it's private baller shit. I need some of that. But I want to go to different cities, like the sexiest cities in the world, and do it there.
Yeah, the streets are still dirty, too. You can just do that here.
No, but the food and the music and the person and the, you know, that's it.
Interesting.
Yeah, man.
I don't think I've ever really had a fantasy like that.
That's, I mean, maybe you and I are the same, because I just don't have one.
I don't, you know.
You're not like, ooh, I just want to get some body oil and rub him down and rub me down and then just slip and slide into heaven.
Yeah. I don't think I've ever really been like, yes, her and I on the beach, or we're on the 37th floor somewhere. I just take off them goddamn drawers and let me get up in that shit. Work this thing out.
So me and my friends, I talk about sex. I don't think it's, and there's no shame in it. So I always ask my friends, and I had a friend of mine, and I asked this question. I'm going to ask the panel the same thing. What would be, as far as like foodie wise, because I like to eat.
Oh, wait. Hold on.
I like to eat now.
Oh, wait a minute.
Oh, what do we got? Zoe's coming in. Jesus. Breaking news. What do we got? Live from
some,
Twitter?
Some of the Twitter feeds are coming back with their fantasies.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
At the Adjuster 7, his fantasy is to have Hekka and Veronica on a patio overlooking the harbor.
Oh, dang.
He's like, get them two butt-ass niggas. Let's hear this. This is at Cash Out 1987 says, I would Miss Ford while covered in popcorn butter at the welfare office.
At the welfare office, though?
Hey.
Niggas are scandalous. That's, niggas ain't got no sense in these streets.
I'm just saying, that's a fantasy.
That's good. The popcorn butter thing is hilarious. That's what I was saying.
What about Joseph Shorter?
I
gotta read his.
Oh, wait a minute. At Cash Out 1987 says that my real fantasy is to fuck every woman on this show.
Well, I think
he's pretty accurate.
No, the one before that, though. I'd fuck Hekka in the ass with eggs, raw butter, and spray salt all over that ass.
Damn.
Yeah, I need to see
Hekka's ass. Look, wow.
Are you sure that's a human? That might be Pinhead from Hellraiser. I don't know.
Wow. I must be hungry, because look, I'm like, you know what? Popcorn butter does sound good.
You want to go to IHOP after? Shit.
Oh. Well, no, can I ask the panel a question?
Sure.
What is your, like, most people do the whipped cream thing, right? I asked my friends the same question. I said, what would be your ideal, like, play food in the bedroom? My homeboy said nacho cheese. And I, on my life, I think he's serious, because I still, nacho cheese? Like, you want to dip my titties in some nacho cheese?
I mean, but your breasts are so voluptuous and pillowy and...
It's going to be a lot of cheese, let me tell you.
And nipply. And just, Jesus, I can imagine. I'm looking now and salivating.
And
I can imagine nacho cheese on those bubbles. Christ alive. It would. Fuck. Yes, that would be nice. Whoever came up with that, he's a genius. I now have a fantasy.
There it is.
Nacho cheese dipped breast. Sounds. Awesome.
It's so awesome.
Yeah, there it is. We're changing lives out here, man.
You guys are helping me.
We're helping Zoe out.
I mean,
let your freak flag fly, man.
I mean, I'm just sitting here, like, looking at Twitter and listening to you guys share. And somebody said, nacho cheese sounds grand. It sounds really good.
You know what? I got another question for the ladies on the panel and any of our callers that are listening. Has there ever been a dick that was too big to fit in your jelly box?
Well, I hear there's a study out that says women don't like really, really big penises because it's too uncomfortable. They don't like that.
Yeah, like there's literally, they're back in college.
And the research says that women who have a man that has a monster-sized penis, they often cheat on him. For a regular size penis. Is this true, ladies? Tweet me at Zoe Williams. I want to know if you guys renounce the schlong. Right? Mm-hmm. If you renounce the billy club.
Yeah, right? Man. I had an experience.
I hear a lot of women say they love big penises.
That's, and that's like the majority, right? Like majority. I am not that girl. I'm just letting you know.
Well, that there was a guy. Me out.
There's a guy in college that we tried. We really did try, and physically, his penis would not go in there. It was not happening. And it was, if you want to get,
you have a little hobbit hole.
I got a small vagina, guys, and it's a real tight, and I'm not trying to get Zoe all excited here with the nacho cheese and tight vagina.
I'm just saying, Jesus, but, it's a hell of a combination. You can't beat those two together.
And honestly, it kind of like turned me, everybody's like, oh, you probably only like black guys. And I'm like, honestly, he might have turned me on to, I'm in my Asian phase right now.
No, no.
I am, no, and no, guess what? He's been giving me the nichama. Fucking orgasm. I can't even talk about it. I'm trying to.
So the fried rice is good for you. Woo,
let me tell you, his egg roll is nice. Yeah. Nice.
Chicken pie tie.
And it's not that. These guys are putting up the pinky. Nah, it's not a pinky, but.
Kung Pao.
It's working. It's definitely not Mandingo either, tearing up my organs and shit. I'm not into that, so. Hmm.
Wow. This is crazy. Mm-hmm. Well, ladies. This has been an evil show. Probably one of the worst ever. I mean, we talked about everything unabashedly. And I think it's important to have these kind of conversations.
Ooh. What? I might have it. Look.
You don't want me to end the show, I guess.
I'm sorry. Look, I just have one more weird. I was watching. This was years ago. I was watching Tyra Banks' show, I think, when she was... And there was a white dude who, what about the feeding? He said he used to smack his chick and feed her mini cupcakes at the same time.
Oh, yeah. That's
some real fat
feederism?
Shit.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
the weirdest to me. I was like, that's that.
I am, at I am Jackie Mack on Twitter says, these Negroes will not kill me. And she's talking about with the big penises. You will not tear the lining in my uterus.
No, that's wrong.
He grows back. Yeah, I know that's right.
Right? I'm saying.
So.
That is not happening. I want to say something really quick, though.
Go ahead.
Can I say something about that really quick?
Mm-hmm.
I did a study. I met this guy one time, and he had the biggest penis. He was small, but he had the biggest penis in the world. And, of course, I would not allow him to run up in me. But as a result, I did a study on astrological information, and I found that men that have the planet Venus in Scorpio... And the sign of Scorpio are men that have really big penises.
Mm.
Well, I don't have that.
So whenever you meet a guy, and you find out his astrological information, mm-hmm. check to see if he has Venus and Scorpio. His penis is going to be huge.
Oh,
I did the study on porn stars, everything. Yeah.
I can't wait to use that. Next time somebody, girl, what's your sign? I'm going to be like, what's yours? Get your big dick away from me.
Oh, my God. I have more questions.
Keep going.
I'm going to ask one more question.
Okay.
Dude, it's like a phenomenon. Women like gagging. Like back in the day, it was traditional head. It wasn't a lot of gagging. It was just traditional bobbing for apples up and down. And then all of a sudden, gagging came into play where women like to choke on the hot link.
Throat? No, I'm not in one of those.
Okay, sorry. You can't be a freak. And I'm then a freak, prude but at I'm a kind. Time. I'm like, it's weird.
Yeah, I'm like the freaky housewife chick who's like, no.
Ashanti.
I don't like to do it, but I know that guys like it. So right before it gets there, I'll pretend that I'm gagging.
I feel that. I do that. Bring
well,
it.
You,
in.
You I do the pretend. You can't gag. Pretend. That's head cheating.
Well, it works for them.
Zoe's
I'm not about to throw up.
I wish y'all could see Zoe's face because he's thinking like, who did that to me?
That's disrespectful. Gag on my like, that's a fake gag.
You don't fake gag on this
bullshit.
Dick.
Fake
right.
gag all day.
Veronica's like so.
You should have Nechama come back to the show and talk about how women can have orgasms out of their throat and ejaculate out of their throat.
What? Now look at their faces. Look at their faces. You just said something. Look at their faces.
So like throw up? Is that would that be like the?
No,
I don't know. She said like
ejaculation.
No. The woman's heart is actually, you know, if you think about the uterus and the heart, they're made of the same material.
Mm-hmm.
And so a woman can have orgasm in her heart, and then
what that creates is this, she's got glands in the side of her throat that actually will produce like ejaculate. And
what?
So if she has enough orgasm in her heart, she will eventually start frothing and coming out of her throat. And I think he's one of the few men on the planet that have actually discovered women are wired this way.
What?
I'm bugging out right
now.
Yeah,
man, we need a Nachama on
this. Yeah, this is crazy. Nachama will be back.
Next, I'm sure this is going to be a point two
right.
on this. Mm-hmm. This is two. We can go for days.
At Dark Knight.
Well,
at Dark Knight 912 says his fantasy is to bang a chick in the botanical gardens with some cowboy boots on and a cowboy hat.
I'm with it.
It's creative.
I'll bring the baby oil boo because that sounds like a good time. Get her done, Kaba.
Wow. Listen, let's do this. Let's go all the way around. Hekka.
Up. I love it.
Hekka, what can I?
Yeah, I was just.
Go ahead.
Okay, go ahead.
Finish your thought and then tell us where you can be found because we got to wrap.
I was just gonna say that I don't like the gag, but I don't like the way sperm either. So,
that's a good woman.
I've never swallowed. I'm sorry. Yeah,
listen, you take your freaky porn half nun ass out of here.
I've never done it.
Well, Hekka, where can they find you, honey?
You can find me by visiting my website at www.hekkaactivated.com. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter as well at Hekka Activated.
Ashanti Ford.
On YouTube, you can hit up my webisodes, Girl on Fire Production, Instagram at Ashanti Ford Live, and then my Twitter, Emergency TV.
Whitney.
What's
Tabor.
Good? What up, y'all? You guys can find me on Instagram, Wildin' Out, at Miss Tabor. Same thing on Twitter, MissTabor.com, Whitney Tabor on Facebook, Whitley, W-H-I-T-L-E-I on Snapchat. That's where you'll see the craziness.
Yes, hopefully some nudity. But
fresh nudes all day.
So yeah, I'm Zoe Williams, the voice of reason. You can find me on my website, IamZoeWilliams.com. Also, we only have 7 days left remaining on our Indiegogo campaign. We're trugging along, 7 days left. That is ZWMS Relationship Dismount Book Tour on Indiegogo.com. Please go there and support my movement. Only 7 days left. We're trying to make this last push to get this book out, The Relationship Dismount, How to Stick the Landing When Leaving a Traumatic Relationship. It's an incredible breakup book that I wrote, 12 chapters. It's amazing. And I'm going to try to get off at least one city, like maybe go to Houston. Right? Should I go to Houston or Atlanta?
Atlanta.
Go to Atlanta and just set it on fire, right?
Take me with
you. Listen, yo. So y'all get at me. Let me know what the deal is. And I appreciate you guys for tuning in. Zoe Williams, I'm out.